You may not recognize the name Rebecca Loos, but for a brief time in 2004, she was one of the most famous women in the world after her scandalous, heated affair with football star David Beckham. At the time, David Beckham was the most famous footballer in England and one half of an iconic couple with the Spice Girl and fashion designer wife, Victoria Beckham. This affair landed her numerous TV appearances, magazine covers, and rumoredly over $1 million. Here is what happened to Rebecca Loos. Let's backtrack a little. Rebecca and David met while she worked as his personal assistant when he was playing at Real Madrid in Spain. It's here that she claims that they had a steamy 4-month affair. They even slept in the home he shared with Victoria. While the Beckham couple vehemently denied all allegations, calling them ludicrous, even going as far as taking a ski trip and being photographed as a happy, smiling family, Loos, well, lost her way. Now, over a decade later, Rebecca Loos is coming out with her truth, revealing scandals that not even Victoria can bury underground anymore. In a BBC documentary, 21st Century Celebrity, she opened up about her wild journey to fame. In this documentary, she revealed that she had been seduced into making a deal with the devil by Max Clifford, a former celebrity agent. Clifford had approached her and said he would negotiate an exclusive with several newspapers and that if she was willing to lay out absolutely all the juicy details, then she would get, in her own words, ridiculous money. She went as far as saying, "Max Clifford sat me down and said, 'Right, let's do a sex tape. You can get £1 million.' I said, 'No, no, I'm very uncomfortable doing that. It was bad enough that I admitted to having done things I'd done.' However, she took the deal. Within weeks, she earned up to £100,000. Within weeks with publicity deals before going on to star in several shows. Ultimately, her overnight notoriety and rise from obscurity left her feeling very unhappy, lonely, and lost. But you never would have guessed that the 15 minutes of fame would have lasted for months. Her wild career as a media personality kicked off in 2004 when she appeared as a hostess on Show News, a Dutch TV program. In October of that year, she made a very controversial appearance on the reality show The Farm, which was a Channel 5 version of the RTE show Celebrity Farm. During her appearance, she, to put it politely, pleasured a pig, sparking absolute outrage. PETA and Media Watch UK demanded that the show be completely taken off the air. But that wasn't the end of her career. No, this second scandal earned her a few more minutes in the spotlight. She went on to appear on Celebrity Love Island. In 2005, along with American fashion model Jenny Shimizu, the two took part in a staged wedding ceremony for Power Lesbian UK TV show in protest of gay marriage laws in the US. Following that, strangely enough, Loos found herself back on the football field. This time, she was the one holding the reins. In 2006, she played for the England women's football team in a charity event for Sky TV. Her athletic streak continued as she ran the London Marathon, raising more than £7,000 in sponsorship for the British Red Cross. Maybe Loos should have stopped while she was ahead. Instead, she jumped on the opportunity to appear on The X Factor, Battle of the Stars. Accompanying her was James Hewitt, another celebrity who had gained notoriety after selling his story of an alleged affair he had had with none other than Princess Diana. That day, Judge Sharon Osbourne, a friend of the Beckhams, heavily criticized the couple. She told Hewitt, "Weren't you in the army? Well, for that performance, you should be shot." And for Loos, she snapped. "Missy, if you get through tonight, you should try doing tomorrow's performance with your knickers on. You've got a very bad vibe that comes from you." Booing ensued, but the viewers saved Loos and Hewitt from being sent home that night. Skip forward to 2007. After that negative experience with The X Factor, Loos scored an appearance on the Spanish version of Survivor. She was a contestant who came in third place. Her exciting career concluded with appearing in Sky TV's Cirque du Célébrité. Throughout the years, she's been featured in numerous covers of FHM, Zoo, Nuts, that topless cover of Playboy magazine, and many others. Years later, Loos admits that her life was crazy, but she lamented the fact that her fame came at a cost, her reputation. The public had quickly branded her as a gold digger, a nickname she couldn't escape no more than the Beckhams could escape every cheating scandal that came their way. But things started to look up for Loos. She went on to meet who would become her future husband, a Norwegian doctor by the name of Sven Kreistarskaya, while on the set of 71 Graden Nord, a Dutch TV program. In 2009, she relocated to Norway. Years later, how is she behaving on social media now that she has a few hundred thousands of dollars in her bank account and more than a few scandals and TV appearances under her belt? Since her life-altering move to Norway, she's made seldom appearances. Her official website states that she's now a mother of two sons, Magnus and Leo, and works as a yoga teacher. According to her, her public persona was too exhausting. She accepts her past, revealing that, "I can't regret things. Yes, of course, I would have done things differently, but it's a part of my path, and it kind of took me to where I am today, and I don't think I want to be anywhere else." She added that once upon a time, she used to leave the house at 9 p.m. and come home at 6 a.m. Now she's in bed by 9 p.m. and up at 6 a.m. That unique, wild, and scandalous career following her infamous alleged affair? That was a nice phase in her late 20s. And that's a wrap for What Happened to Rebecca Loos. What did you think of her wild story? Do you believe her allegations against David Beckham? What about where she is now? Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. If you enjoy this video, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel, What Happened, for more stories like this. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.